What is that spiral arm in the center of the Milky Way? I bet you know pretty well we're living on a planet, Earth, orbiting a star, the Sun, orbiting around a galactic center, the Milky Way galactic center. Our distance from it is about 8 kiloparsecs, a huge distance compared to the one we are used to, but still a very small one if you think about the large-scale structure of the universe. For example, the measuring unit for the distance between galaxies is the megaparsec, which corresponds to 10 to the 6th parsecs, or 10 to the 3rd kiloparsec. 8 kpc corresponds to about one-third the distance from the center of the Milky Way galaxy to its outer edges, and the Sun is located in a smaller spiral arm between two large arms called the Orion Arm. In fact, the Milky Way is a spiral galaxy named by its spiral structures that extend from the center into the galactic disk. The spiral arms are sites of ongoing star formation and are brighter than the surrounding disk because of the young, hot OB stars that inhabit them. A spiral arm orbit is pretty well defined, with some defined orientation that is often due to cinematic properties of the stars and gas populating it. In other words, we can reasonably assume to know the path and orientation of a spiral arm in our galaxy. A new discovery suggests that one of our galaxy's spiral arms, located some 4,000 light years from Earth, is jutting out at a weird angle. They're calling it a break in one of the Milky Way's spiral arms. Keep watching the video to get to know more about this unexpected break. Imagine being alone in the middle of a forest. You're surrounded by all kinds of trees, and you have to hurry up because the night is coming, and it would be very dangerous for you to stay there when the Sun will be gone. How could you tell where there's a way out? If there was a friend of yours watching you from a top view, he would have perfect control of the territory, so you could ask him to guide you out of there. But suppose you have no friends, unless you are very lucky, or unless you are Bear Grylls. You're gonna probably be stuck there, because you simply can't see the forest for the trees and you have no chance for a top view. Well, this is pretty much the same situation that astronomers face when it's time to understand how our galaxy is. Sometimes you can't see the galaxy for the stars. Because we're inside the Milky Way and we can't get a complete view of the forest of stars surrounding us, this is why it's so difficult to understand its properties and features. And when a team of astronomers start studying in detail some part of our galaxy, it means that it's probably time for new discoveries. That's why astronomers from all over the world weren't surprised to hear that we found a break in one of the Milky Way's spiral arms. But what is it? Well, this break, which extends from the Sagittarius arm of our Milky Way galaxy, has a strange orientation. Of course, other pieces of spiral arms exist with very peculiar orientations, but this is the first major structure identified with such a dramatic one. The scientists published their discovery on July 21, 2021, in the peer-reviewed journal Astronomy and Astrophysics. Let's try to understand where this break is located. We could say that the splintered region of the Sagittarius spiral arm extends for some 3,000 light years at a sharp angle from the main arm, that is the tangent to the start of the Sagittarius spiral arm, which lies at a galactic latitude of about minus 17 degrees. But we're not astronomers, and these numbers are not telling us much. Maybe things are clearer if we talk in terms of constellations. That region of sky is the region we're looking toward when we gaze at the constellations Sagittarius and Serpens Cauda and the Milky Way that flows behind these stars. Some of the stars and nebulae located in the spiral arm break are the most famous in the heavens. They include the Eagle Nebula, which is known for the Hubble Space Telescope's Pillars of Creation photo, and it includes the Omega Nebula and the Trifid Nebula and Lagoon Nebula. These nebulae are often photographed together. Here we are. Now you get me. Now that we know what the break is and where it's located, let's see how scientists found it. Of course, they needed a telescope, or better to say, they needed data from a telescope. That's why they turned their attention to NASA's Spitzer Space Telescope. Launched in 2003, NASA's Spitzer Space Telescope was the fourth and final addition to NASA's Great Observatory program. Spitzer's mission was to become NASA's premier infrared light observatory. offering astronomers the chance to study the universe in this critical part of the electromagnetic spectrum of light with unprecedented clarity and sensitivity. Thanks to it, they analyzed a bunch of data regarding young stars that the telescope's infrared vision could see hiding within these nebulae. They also used data from ESA's Gaia mission to measure precise distances to the stars. Gaia is a very important instrument that will lead astronomers from all over the world to a better understanding of the place we are living in, and more generally, our entire universe. It is so precise that some astronomers started using its data before they were made official. Alberto Crones Martins, one of the authors of the study from the University of California, Irvine, said that distances are among the most difficult things to measure in astronomy. It is only the recent, direct distance measurements from Gaia that make the geometry of this new structure so apparent. The combination of the two sets of data revealed that the splintered segment of the Sagittarius arm contains young stars moving at nearly the same velocity and in the same direction through space. When they put the Gaia and Spitzer data together and finally see this detailed three-dimensional map, they could see that there was quite a bit of complexity in this region that just hadn't been apparent before. The scientists do not yet fully understand why all that star material forms into these spiral arms. While astronomers have discovered groups, local groups, and clusters of galaxies in an estimated number of more than 100 billion, they have not been able to completely model and map out our own Milky Way galaxy for the reasons we mentioned above. Okay, now that we know how this discovery was made, let's try to answer this question. Why is the break important? Before finding out the answer to the question, be sure to like or dislike the video so that we can continue to improve and make these videos better for you, the viewer. Plus, be sure to subscribe to the channel by clicking the bell so that you don't miss any of our weekly videos. Here's where you'll learn something new today. The arms of a spiral galaxy are measured in something called a pitch. The pitch is said to be 0 degrees if a spiral is so tightly wound that it forms a circle. Instead, if a spiral arm opens up, the pitch goes up. Now, a key property of spiral arms is indeed how tightly they wind through a galaxy and what their pitch is. Analyzing the Milky Way's galaxy structure and putting all the physics we know in our best stellar models, we found that the Sagittarius arm should form a spiral that has a pitch angle of about 12 degrees. But these were just models. The problem and the amazingness of this discovery came when they found the structure they examined really stands out at an angle of nearly 60 degrees. It's a huge disagreement with models. It's a huge pitch. This spiral arm is very, very loose. Scientists have seen jutting breaks in spiral arms of other galaxies before, but this is the first time such a structure has been identified in our own galaxy. This is an important result that breaks down our best models and suggests to us to revisit theories and make new detailed measurements of the motion of individual stars. The stars in the spiral arm break likely form together. Forces within the Milky Way, such as gravity and shear from the galaxy's spin, likely influence them. This discovery acts as a reminder that there are many uncertainties about the large-scale structure of the Milky Way, and we need to look at the details if we want to understand that bigger picture. That is to say, we have to study every single tree if we want to get out of the forest. Good luck! This structure is a small piece of the Milky Way, but it could tell us something significant about the galaxy as a whole. As you can see, once again, reality surprises us. It's always way more complex than we think, and the only thing we can do is keep observing it and try to understand a little bit more of it. Piece by piece, tree by tree, star by star, we are building our picture of the universe. Sometimes it's a blurred one, sometimes it gets clearer. But the puzzle is a big one. The forest is a messy one. The galaxy is a peculiar one. The only thing we can do, as always, is to keep it curious. That's all for this video. Thanks for watching, everyone. Are you in love with the Milky Way galaxy? What's the weirdest thing you know about it? Is there anything more you want to hear? Let us know in the comments below. Be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you next time on the channel.